this area of Northwest Ohio, Wauseon, is a small farming community and industrial community. It's close to Toledo, Ohio, which is more industrial, you know, manufacturing, just a lot of farmland out here, you know, in woods. The forest industry here, there's not a huge amount of it because there's a lot of farm ground, but there is some, you know, there's still a good amount of forest in, you know, industry here, but not as much as compared to other areas where there's, where it's predominantly forested.
In Fulton County, there's 3 sawmills. We're one of the bigger ones. There's a couple other guys, one of them's our cousin, another guy that we know really well. We each got our own kind of niche things, but we help each other on certain things. Everybody kind of fits a need and has a customer base, you know, to fit different needs for people.
We incorporated the business in 97. At that time, it was our father, Luther, David and I, and it was just a small side business because we worked full-time jobs, and then we farmed sawing that during the winter and off time, you know, for when we wasn't farming or working. We've had a sawmill in the family for generations. Our grandfather had a sawmill and that, so that's kind of where we got started, you know, with everything. We unload the logs and then we'll scale them for how much board footage there is. We'll sort them according to species, quality, and that, whether it's pallet material or stuff that's supposed to go, you know, go into grade lumber. If it's pallet material, we don't sort too much other than softwoods out from the denser hardwoods. When the log comes in, we're sawing it. If it's pallet material, it's a lot of 3x4s or 4x4s. Sometimes we do 6x6s and that bigger stuff. That'll, you know, get usually all chopped the length and stacked and go out. And when we're doing grade lumber, when it comes in, it'll get whatever thickness we're running or species we're running. It'll just get sawed, edged what needs to be edged, and then stacked up and then taken out.
Operating the 4500 has shown that it's versatile. Biggest thing, it's got more hydraulic power.
So that makes it a lot easier handling bigger logs.
This is huge for us. We've worked and worked and worked, and this is kind of like a present. We've earned the right to have a 4500. We finally paid all our dues and worked our way up. This fits us.
With this new edger having a lot more width to it, and then with having laser lines on it to know where the blades are at and be able to have the presets on there too is real nice. You can just hit a button and it automatically goes to what a board width, and you don't have to sit there and guess, you don't have to fumble with the buttons. It's made it a lot faster, and the cutting speed is a lot faster too. Wood-Mizer blades, we've always had the best luck with them. We had tried some other blades, but we didn't see as good a quality. Plus, Wood-Mizer blades was always a better value on the price, especially, you know, where we could buy quantity and get more off of them. Wood-Mizer contributes a great deal to our quality. The quality of how they construct their mills and their engineering in it to help you maintain your production, but also maintain your quality of cutting.
Wood-Mizer's equipment, every mill we've had holds to its tolerances and does a good job. So that's why we keep going back and getting one. And this is the fourth one in progression. that we've had, and that's why we keep going back.